Okay, hello my dear friends, welcome to the next discussion on capital budgeting applicable for CA final SFM old syllabus. So in the previous problem we discussed about probability concept, decision tree concept, scenario analysis, joint probability concept. Now let's do one more problem, slightly different but still relevant. Question number 5. XYZ Limited is planning to procure the machine at an investment of 40 lakhs. The expected cash flow after tax for the next 3 years is as follows. Year, probability. Year 2, probability. Year 3, probability. The company wishes to consider all possible risk factors relating to machine. The company wants to know expected NPV of this proposal assuming independent probability distribution with 7% risk-free rate of interest, possible deviation from expected values. Possible deviation means standard deviation, standard deviation. We'll come to the second part. First, let us get the first part right. So, in the previous problem, first year probability is connected with second year probability. So, we multiplied the both and called as joint probability. Correct? Here, first year probability, second year probability, third year probability are independent probability. There is nothing connecting between them. Independent probability distribution. So we compute first year cash flow separately, second year cash flow separately, and third year cash flow separately. Then we discount all of them, subtract investment. What you get is NPV. So concentrate. First year cash flow is there. How do we calculate? 12 into 0.1, 15 into 0.2, 18 into 0.3, 32 into 0.3 and total it up. X into P, that product total. So I am doing it. Please take a look at it. For first year, 12 into 0.1, 1.2, 15 into 0.2, 3, 18 into 0.4, 7.2, 32 into 0.3, 9.6, total 21. Don't write it down. I've given the solution in the material. Just take a look at it. Understand. That is sufficient. Similarly, for cash flow for year 2, 12 into 0.1, 18 into 0.3, 13 into 0.4, 14 into 0.2, total 26.6. Then third year, 18 into 0.2, 20 into 0.5, 32 into 0.2, 45 into 0.1, total. So we get the expected cash flow for year 1, expected cash flow for year 2 and expected cash flow for year 3. Fine? Nice. Now, year 1 we got 21, year 2 we got 26.6, year 3 we got 24.5, 3 year cash flow we got, apply discounting factor at 7%, which I have done. So 21 into 0.9346, 26 into 0.8734, 24.5 into 0.8163, 2 the total, 62.86, subtract investments, the resultant what you get is NPV. That's all, expected NPV. Now coming to deviation, standard deviation. Standard deviation goes like this, please observe. The formula for standard deviation is square root of summation x minus x bar the whole square multiplied by p. You need one column for x bar, we got it. One column for x minus x bar, one column for x minus x bar whole square, and one more column for x minus x bar whole square multiplied by p. I hope you have done all these calculations in portfolio management. So I'm not discussing the concept of standard deviation. If you want, please refer my portfolio management. From the root I have explained what is standard deviation, what is variance, why should I do square, what is the square root, does the standard deviation means plus or minus, what is the area of deviation. I have discussed that in detail in portfolio management. Okay. So if I do a square root, I get standard deviation. If I don't do a square root, basically if I square this, then what I get is variance. You know it? I hope you know it. If not, please refer my basic discussion on portfolio management. Fine. Now we should compute the standard deviation for first year, standard deviation for second year, standard deviation for third year. Then I'm going to bring it down to today value. So please observe, solution is there in the material. So x minus x bar, 12 minus 21, minus 9, 15 minus 21, minus 6, 18 minus 21, minus 3, 32 minus 21, 11. Then x minus x bar whole square, that is 9 square, 81, minus 6 square, 36, minus 3 square, 9, 11 square, 121. We need x minus x bar whole square into p, that is 81 into 0.1, that is 8.1, 36 into 0.2, 7.2, then 9 into 0.4, 3.6, 121 into 0.3, 36.3, do the total, you get 55.2. Like that, you do for year 2, like that you do for year 3, you get 3 variances. So please check the calculation. I'll give you 2 minutes. Please check the calculation. You should have got 55.2 variance for first year, variance for first year, and 84.04 variance for second year, and 71.86 variance for third year. 2 minutes. Please take a look at this calculation. Then we'll go further. Okay, hopefully you had gone through those calculations. Done? Okay, now. So, what did we do previously? We got the first year cash flow, second year cash flow, third year cash flow. All the cash flows multiplied by discounting factor, we got the project cash flow, subtract investment, we got the project NPV. Same logic, same process, I will apply for deviations. But one important point, I'm not going to use standard deviation of individual years because standard deviation cannot be used for simplifications, portfolio management. Security 1 standard deviation plus Securities 2 standard deviation is not done. First security standard deviation square, second security standard deviation square, then only we can bring it to portfolio. Portfolio management is the basics. Please go through it once. In other words, standard deviation is used for expression of risk, variance is used for simplification of risk. So when I want project risk, year 1, year 2, year 3, year 1, year 2, year 3. These 3 years, I'm not going to calculate standard deviations. I'm going to make use of variance because when I need to mix it, when I need to simplify it, standard deviation is not used. Instead, variance is used, which is what we got already. Variance of year 1, variance of year 2, variance of year 3, all the 3 will be mixed. But these are different 3 years. So, look at the next table. Year 1, 55.2. Year 2, 84.04. Year 3, 71.86. Now, this I have to multiply it by discounting factor. Please observe. Give me 1 second. Please stay focused on this point. Cash flow multiplied by discounting factor, discounted cash flow. Correct? Now for variance, it's not sufficient if I take discounting factor because variance means square. Remember portfolio management, sigma 1 square, W 1 square, sigma 2 square, W 2 square. Aware of it? Nice. So here what should we should do? Variance we have taken, multiplied by not discounting factor, discounting factor square. 0.9346 square is 0.8734. 0.8734 square, 0.7629. 0.8163 square, 0.6663. Then you know, cash flow into discounting factor. So 55.2 into 0.8734, 48.21. 84.04 into 0.7629, 64.11. 71.84 into 0.6663, 47.88. Do the total, 160. This is variance. Take a square root, you get standard deviation. In fact, institute give you this formula, logical formula, that is variance by 1 plus xi square, because discounting factor squared. Second year variance by second year discounting factor is 1 plus xi. 1 plus xi square becomes 1 plus xi 4. Third year sigma 3 square divided by what is third year discounting factor? 1 plus xi to the power of 3 square. 3 whole square, that is power of a power is multiplied. 3 into 2 becomes 6. So first year discounting factor square, second year discounting factor square, third year discounting factor square. If I simplify it, you get the same answer, 12.66. You will get 12.66. You can try it in the calculator. Fine. So I'll give you 2 minutes. Please go through the calculations. See if you have any doubts. Nothing to write down. Everything is there in the material. Please go through it slowly. 2 minutes. Okay, so hope you have gone through that. That is your question number 5. Let's move on to question number 6. This is purely decision tree problem. This solution is not there in the material. You have to write it down. Okay, L&R Limited wishes to develop a new virus cleaner software. Read carefully. The cost of the pilot project is 2,40,000. Presently, the chances of the product being successfully launched on a commercial scale are rated at 50%. In case it does succeed, L&R can further invest a sum of rupees 20 lakh to market the product. Such an effort can generate perpetually an annual net after-tax income of 4 lakhs. Even if the commercial launch fails, they can make an investment of smaller amount of 12 lakhs with hope of gaining perpetually a sum of 1 lakh. Evaluate the proposal, adopting decision tree approach, applicable discounting rate 10%. I'll give you 1 minute. Read the problem once more. Tell me in this problem, how many decision points are there? Decision points. Read and think. 1 minute. Got it? In this problem, there are three decision points. Three. First decision is whether to do the pilot project or not. Okay? Then second decision is if it is successful, then should I invest it or not? In case it does succeed, it can further invest. Please observe, it can further invest. So invest or not is second decision. And third decision, in case if the pilot project is a failure, again you can invest or not. Invest or not. So basically there are three decisions. Today pilot, then if it is successful, further invest or not. Second, if it is failure, further invest or not. Total three decision points. And first decision actually based on the next two decisions. You should work backwards. If it is successful, what is the value? Come back. If it is failure, what is the value? Come back. Then using these two, what is the value today? So you should move from left to right in the time sequence. But in the calculation, you should move from right to left. So first calculate D2, D3, then come to D1. Okay. Please observe. I'll explain cleanly once more now. Cost of the pilot project is 2,40,000. It can succeed or it can be a failure. The probability of success is 50%. The probability of failure is also 50%. If it is successful, you can further invest or you need not invest. You understand? This is D1 and this is D2. You can invest or you need not invest. If it is a failure, still you can make investment or you need not make an investment, that is D3. Now, I'll give time. I think solution is there in the material. I've given the screenshot of this, so nothing to write down, just understand sufficient. If you invest, in the event that the project is successful, then investment is 20 lakh. What is the value you get? 4 lakh. Perpetually. What is the value of perpetuity? Cash flow by interest rate. Remember, value of perpetuity, present value of perpetuity, annuity by interest rate. Or if you know Gordon growth model, cash flow by K minus G, D1 by K minus G. No growth rate means D1 by K only. So 4 lakh by 0.1, cash flow by rate of interest, perpetuity value 40 lakh, net benefit 20 lakh. That is if you invest. If you don't invest, zero. Which one will you choose? If you invest, you get a benefit of 20 lakh. If you don't invest, zero benefit, whichever is higher. So D2 is to invest and make a benefit of 20 lakh. D2 is decided. Let's come to D3. Investment 20 lakh. Benefit here, how much you get perpetually? 1 lakh forever. So 1 lakh by 0.1. Cash flow by rate of interest, perpetuity value 10 lakh. You invested 12 lakh, you are getting 10 lakh, net benefit is 2 lakh, loss. That is if you invest. You can invest. It's not that you should invest. You can. You have a decision to make. It's a choice. Correct? Now, if you don't invest, nothing to lose. Zero. Which one will you choose now? Minus 2 lakh or zero? If you invest, you lose 2 lakh. Don't invest. So D3 is don't invest and the benefit is zero. Now, what are the probabilities? This D2 probability 50%, benefit is 20 lakh. D3 probability is also 50%, benefit is zero. That's what we are selecting. So net amount is 20 lakh into 0.5, 20 lakh into 0.5, 0 into 0.5, net is 10 lakh and cost of the pilot project is 2,40,000. So net benefit is there. That means benefit is more than cost. So we say that project should be accepted. So 1 minute, please take a look at this. I've given the solution in the material. Nothing to write down. ओके ओके सो होप यू गॉट इट माय डियर फ्रेंड्स. लेट्स मूव ऑन. ओके नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज रिगार्डिंग रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ मशीन. वेदर टू रिप्लेस और नॉट इज अ आईपीसीसी लेवल क्वेश्चन. इट कैन स्टिल बी आस्क्ड. इफ दे आस्क यू शुड द मशीन बी रिप्लेस्ड और नॉट, कंप्यूट एनपीवी. एनपीवी इज पॉजिटिव, रिप्लेस द मशीन. एनपीवी इज नेगेटिव, डोंट रिप्लेस द मशीन. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू डू दैट प्रॉब्लम. द प्रॉब्लम इज वंस यू परचेज द मशीन व्हेन इट शुड बी रिप्लेस्ड. लेट्स से यूजफुल लाइफ इज 5 years. Should I replace after year 1, after year 2, after year 3, after year 4, after year 5? 5 alternatives are there. 5 times of replacement. And I will compute NPV under all 5 alternatives. But they are not comparable because the term under each alternative is different. How do you do in such case when the useful life is different? Projects of unequal life. First problem we discussed in this segment. I mean in the previous segment at final level. EAC, the present value what you get, divide by annuity factor, you get equated annual cost, and that is to be compared when the project is unequal life. The same thing we are going to apply. Let's do a problem. Now, nothing to write down, solution is there in the material, stay focused, just understand, nothing else is required. No need to write down, just understand. Let's read. X Limited is a taxi operator. Each taxi to cost to company 4 lakh, useful life of 3 years. Taxi's operating cost for each 3 years and salvage value at the end of year 3 is as follows. You are required to determine the optimal replacement period of taxi if cost of capital of X Limited is 10%. Just 1 minute, just read the problem. Okay. Now, just observe here. Now, you have 3 years. You can replace after year one. You can replace after year two. You can replace after year 3. If you replace after year 1, today anyway you have to pay 4 lakh. After year 1, you have to pay 1,80,000 and you get resale value of 2,80,000. First option. Second option, you have to pay 4 lakh today. You have to pay 1,80,000 after year 1. You have to pay 2,10,000 after year 2. And you get 2,30,000 after year 2, salvage value, inflow. So 4 lakh is outflow, 1 lakh 80 is outflow, 2 lakh 10 is outflow, 2 lakh 30 is inflow. Remember, again don't take 2 lakh 80 into consideration. You can't sell 2 times. Operating cost will come in both the years. Resale value will not come in both the years. You can't sell 2 times. No double acting and all here. Okay. So if you are taking year 3 replacement, 4 lakh today, 1,80,000 after year 1, 2,10,000 after year 2, 2,38,000 after year 3, and 1,68,000 inflow after year 3. Don't take 2,80,000, 2,30,000 then. Okay? So that's what happening here. Operating cost will come every year, but salvage value will come only in the year of sale, not prior to that. Okay? Solution is there. Take a look at this. If you replace after year 1, today cash flow 4 lakh minus. First year outflow, operating cost 1,80,000. second year, I mean, first year out inflow, 2,80,000, salvage value, replace after year one, multiplied by discounting factor, you get this present value, and you get the NPV minus 4 lakh, this present value, net present value. If I take it replacement after year two, year one, cash flow 1,80,000, first year operating cost, second year operating cost 2,10,000 outflow, and second year you get the resale value, salvage value, because you're selling after second year, that is 2,30,000.8265. Do the total, NPV will become 5,47,108. Now if you replace after year 3, initial cash flow 4 lakh, first year operating cost will come 1,80,000, second year operating cost will come 2,10,000, third year operating cost will come, and third year replacement, so third year salvage value inflow 1,68,000, discounting factor NPV comes to 7,89,000. That is also inflow. So can I say that these are NPV, take whichever is less, because all are negative, you say this one, and don't tell all three are negative, so don't replace at all. No, this is a costing problem, which means we are not considering the cash flow generated by these machines, this car, this taxi. So we have to choose whichever is cheaper. Don't say all NPV are negative, so don't replace it. No, don't go for it. We have to choose one of them. Since it's a costing decision, you choose whichever is cheaper. Now, this NPV relates to three different periods, unequal life, not comparable. So these three NPVs, 309,100, I'm rounding it off. 547,100, I'm rounding it off. 789,801, I'm rounding it off. Well, let me take the actual number only. What will happen? 309,090, 547,108, 789,801. Just give me 1 second. Divide by annuity factor. Just calculate how much you get. Please calculate in your material ones. Just calculate. So we get got it? So since the time period is different, unequal life, all the NPVs are divided by respective annuity factor, 0.909 only for the first, then these two numbers are added, you get 1.735, then three discounting factors added, you get 2.486. So those are the EAC you get. Now they are comparable, everything annual terms, then you choose whichever is cheaper. Second option is cheaper, so decision is replace after 2 years. Replace after 2 years. So solution is the material, just go through it. Simple step, when to replace, all three options, compute NPV, divide by annuity factor, choose whichever is less, that is based on EAC. NPV by annuity factor is EAC, EAC, choose whichever is less. That's all, done. Next, nothing to write, solution is there. Okay, let's go to next one, question number 8. This is basically inflation. For that you need to understand two terms. One is called as real, other is called as nominal. Real cash flow means without inflation, and nominal cash flow means with inflation. And in the problem, whenever they give you discounting factor, it's always nominal discounting rate. So what happens, what is the problem will happen is, when they give you cash flow in real, discounting rate in real, no problem. Cash flow in nominal, discounting rate in nominal, no problem. But when they give you cash flow in real, discounting rate in nominal, there is a problem. Now, cash flow in real, discounting rate in nominal. You can either convert cash flow into nominal terms, or you can convert discounting rate into real terms. There is a formula. 1 plus real rate into 1 plus inflation is 1 plus nominal rate. But I don't want to go through that route, because when every year inflation is different, for example, in this problem what we are doing now, that method of 1 plus real, 1 plus nominal, 1 plus real, 1 plus inflation equal to 1 plus nominal will change every year. It's going to confuse everything. I don't want to go through that method. When they give you real cash flows, what you do is convert that into nominal cash flow by doing 1 plus R, compounded increase by inflation. Cash flow without inflation is real. Multiplied by inflation, increased by inflation, including inflation is nominal. That's all. Fine? So, take a look at this one. Question number 8. XYZ Limited requires 8 lakh for a new project, useful life 4 years, salvage value nil, depreciation charge 2 lakh per annum, expected revenue and cost, excluding depreciation, ignoring inflation. Ignoring inflation means real cash flow. So we have to increase it by inflation rate. Increase it by inflation rate. For depreciation, don't apply any inflation. Depreciation, no inflation. Fine? Take a look at the question. So year 1, 2, 3, 4, revenue, cost. Applicable tax rate 60%, cost of capital 10%, calculate NPV if inflation rate for revenue and cost are as follows. Let's concentrate on the first one very importantly. 6 lakh is ignoring inflation, which means real. But when they give you just cost of capital, it is nominal. So I have to convert this real cash flow into nominal cash flow. So I'll multiply it by 1 plus rate of inflation, which means 6 lakh into 1 plus rate of inflation 10%, that is 6,60,000. So while calculating my NPV, I will not consider 6 lakh, I will consider 6,60,000. Fine? One basic question, my dear friends. Can you tell me when is 6 lakh happening, when is 6,60,000 happening? 6 lakh happening after year 1. 6,60,000 also happening after year 1. Then what is the difference? Sir, with inflation, without inflation. That I only told you, no? What is the difference? Sir, real nominal. That also I only told you. When is 6 lakh happening? At the end of year 1. When is 6,60,000 happening? At the end of year 1. Then what is the difference? Inflation. You are right, but you are not really understanding. Understand now. 6 lakh is happening at the end of year 1. 6,60,000 also happening at the end of year 1. For you to understand, break down sales into two parts, price and value. Let's say, for example, purpose, price in this case is 60 rupees, or let's say 10 rupees, and volume is 60,000 units. So what is the price now? 60,000 into 10, 6 lakh. When you are selling 60,000 units? After year 1. 60,000 units after year one. So 60,000 into 10, 6 lakh. But if inflation happens by 10%, then what will happen to price? 11 rupees, increasing by 10%. 10 plus 10%, 11. And volume how much? Volume is not increasing. 60,000, 60,000 into 11, that's what gives me 6,60,000. Are you understanding the difference, sir? 60,000 volume is not changing, price only is changing, inflation is only change in price. To explain in simple words, 6 lakh is sales at the end of year 1 in current price. 6,60,000 is the sales at the end of year 1 in year 1 price. Volume sales is taking place at the end of year 1. But at what price? At today price or after year 1 price? Today price is 10 rupees real cash flow and year 1 price 11 rupees nominal cash flow. In fact, if you understand this concept, so many things you can understand. In costing, they call it as escalation clause, contract costing also there. In standard costing, you can say price variance, quantity variance. In economics, you can say real GDP, nominal GDP. Heard of it somewhere? Same concepts. Anyway, bring back for us, calculation is very simple. 6 lakh into 1.1. And second one we are doing, 7 lakh, how much? Into 1.1, into 1.09. Because second year price means it has to come from 0 year to 1 year to second year. It has to move in a stepwise manner. You understand, right? So from year 0 to year 2 means from year 0 to year 1, from year 1 to year 2. So 1 plus 0.1, then 1 plus 0.09, basics, multiplication model, basic chapter, 1 plus R, 1 plus R, 1 plus R, inflation compounds, hope you are able to follow it. Now you look at the solution, you will be able to understand. Initial cash flow 8 lakh, year 1, revenue 6 lakh, 7 lakh, 8 lakh, then 6 lakh into 1.1 becomes 6,60,000, I explained, second year observe, 6 lakh, into 1.1, into 1.09, into 1 plus inflation, into 1 plus second year inflation, third year when you do, first year inflation, second year inflation, third year inflation, year 0 to year 1 to year 2 to year 3, in a compounding manner, growing manner, basics, 1 plus R, 1 plus R, 1 plus R. Then, in the material I have given these numbers, but I have not shown you this calculation. Please mark it down in your material. Same thing applies for cost also. Cost inflation is different. First year, second year and first year. First year, second year, third year. First year, second year, third year. That will give you the cost. So I will give you 2 minutes. Please mark down these cost calculations. In the material I have given the numbers, but calculations I have not given. So please mark it 2 minutes. Okay, hope you have written down. Now revenue and cost is done. Depreciation, 8 lakh, no scrap value. So 8 lakh by 4 years, 2 lakh per annum. They also have given 2 lakh. Now cash flow, I did not want to spend too much of time. Revenue minus cost minus depreciation, profit before tax, profit after tax plus depreciation, too long method. So what I did, revenue minus cost, I got profit. After tax, I multiplied by 1 minus t, correct? Then what I did, plus depreciation into t. I'll just show you for first year. Revenue 6,60,000. Cost 3,36,000. Into 1 minus tax rate, 1 minus 0.6. Plus depreciation 2 lakh. Into tax rate 0.6. That gives me 2,49,600. This number I got it. Please check that number, see if you are getting it. Like that I did for every year. Revenue minus cost, column 3 minus column 5, into 1 minus t, 1 minus 0.6. Then column 6, depreciation into tax rate, that is into 0.6. First year I get 2,49,600. Like that you can do for every year. Fourth year end, nothing is there, no salvage value, no scrap value, zero. So no terminal value. Then all these cash flows, what you got, discounted by 10%, I've done in the material. Then you get the present value. Then 8 lakh investment, 9,07,000 is your present value of inflows, terminal value is zero, NPV you get 107. Since NPV is positive, project should be accepted. So please take a look at this. 1 minute. After that, we can go to last topic in capital budgeting, that is sensitivity analysis. Please take a look at solution. 1 minute. Done? Okay. Now, sensitivity analysis. Very simple. No new formulas, just the concept. What is sensitivity? How you react? See, you ask yourself, how you react when your mobile falls versus your friend fall. If your friend is falling down, you call everybody. See, your friend is falling down. Entertainment. If a mobile is falling down, your heart is only falling down. Many people have got heart attacks in their life by seeing their mobile falling into the river and all. Very sensitive, very sensitive. Those days when we used to use mobile phone Nokia, if it's dropped down on somebody, we used to ask, are you okay? Mobile has fallen down on you. Now, if mobile falls on somebody, you don't care about somebody, mobile. Anything happened to mobile? Because your life is in that mobile. Anyway, you understand the sensitivity level. How do we react? In your first year of articleship, your boss calls you for small, small things. You will be like, what I've done in my life? Why is he scolding me? You feel so bad. In the final year, your boss calls you No reaction. You scold, scold, no problem, scold. And if one day if he's not scolding, you'll be like, why is he not scolding me? Or in the first year, you'll be like, Papa me, he's scolding me. In the final year, Papa him, he's scolding me. Your sensitivity level have changed. Anyway, come back to the subject now. What is sensitivity here? Project is comprising of various factors: cash flow, discounting factor, investment, NPV. Correct? Now, whenever these factor changes, NPV will change. If your sales units change, if your fixed cost change, if your variable cost change, selling price change, discounting rate change, any of these things changes, NPV will change. So when one of these changes, how much NPV will change, how much NPV will react? The reaction of NPV with respect to changes in the variable is called as sensitivity. Now, how do you compute that number? Measurement. You can understand by various ways. For example, if sales volume reduced by 10%, how much NPV will reduce by? Let's say NPV reduced by 20%. Sales volume reduced by 10%, NPV reduced by 20%, reaction is double. So we say sensitivity is 2. Change in NPV by change in selling price. But like that, which percentage to assume in exam? Different percentage you assume, different ratio you get. So we'll go to the extreme understanding. Extreme understanding means, what is the NPV that maximum I can tolerate? What is the change in NPV I can tolerate? Not below zero. Not below zero. Because if it comes to below zero, NPV loss, project is not financially viable. So change in variable up to the point NPV becoming zero, that is NPV reduced by 100%, we can accept. What is that change? What is that percentage change? Is that variable sensitivity? So what is the change in the variable? Such a way that NPV will come to zero, that movement, that proportion, that percentage change, we call it as sensitivity, and we'll calculate for one variable at a time. So let me show you how to calculate. Question number 9. The following information applies to new project: initial investment 1,25,000, selling price per unit rupees 100, variable cost per unit rupees 30, fixed cost for the period rupees 1 lakh, sales volume 2000 units, life 5 years, discounting rate 10%, required project's NPV, and show how sensitive the results are to the selling price, variable cost, fixed cost and initial investment. First, you get the current NPV. I have given the solution in the middle, just take a look at it. Selling price 100, 2000 units, 2 lakh rupees. Variable cost 30 rupees into 2000 units, 60,000. Fixed cost 1 lakh, no discounting rate, no depreciation, no tax, so cash flow 40,000. So investment 1,25,000, 40,000 annual cash flow, annuity factor 10% for 5 years, 3.791, that NPV will come to 26,640. Fine. Now, what is NPV? Basically, what we did now: 100 rupees selling price minus variable cost 30, contribution per unit, multiplied by number of units 2000 minus fixed cost into annuity factor minus investment. So whatever I did, only I'm showing you by way of calculation. Now, each of these variables: selling price, variable cost, number of units, annuity factor, investments, are all called as different variables. If I want to understand about, sensitivity to changes in selling price, what do you do? Find out the selling price such a way that NPV will become zero. Once more, find out the selling price such a way that NPV will become zero. So you can assume selling price as X. If you don't like x, if you remember your past life x, it's okay. Don't assume it as x. Assume as selling price only. Simplify. I've done. I've given the solution material also. Please take a look at it. Selling price as SP, NPV 0. If I simplify mathematically, I get 96.49. So from current selling price of 100 rupees, if it becomes 96.49, that is 3.51 by 100, that is 3.51%. So if selling price falls by 3.51%, NPV will fall by 100%. That selling price sensitivity is 3.51. A mathematical given in the material, you can go through it. Like this, what should you do? Next, if I want variable cost sensitivity, selling price you take it as 100, variable cost you take it as x, solve for x. From 30 rupees to that number, I think that is 33 something you get. You can try it out. So 30 rupees to 33, approximately 11% change. So variable cost sensitivity is 11%. Change one variable at a time. Don't change all the variables parallelly. X, Y, Z, everything will come. So assume the variable as unknown number, equate the NPV to 0. From the current variable to the new variable, compute the percentage change. That is called as sensitivity. Please write down the notes. Note. Sensitivity calculation, two steps. Sensitivity calculation, two steps. Step one. Compute the variable such a way that NPV becomes zero. NPV becomes zero. NPV becomes zero. Second step. Sensitivity of the variable equals value computed in step one minus given variable divided by given variable into 100. That is, see, let's say for variable cost, if you simplify, you get approximately 33. You can calculate. I don't know the number. Approximately, you get 33. Minus given variable 30, divided by given variable 30 into 100, approximately, you get 10%. So variable cost sensitivity is, I think, not 10. I think 11% you get, approximately. Some 10, 11%. Approximately, you get. That is, variable in step 1 minus given variable by given variable into 100 is the variable, particular variable sensitivity. Okay, now, you can do like this. That is what you are going to get, the straightforward mathematical answer. But I would like to show you one more method. Institute has followed this also. But for me, just a formula is not sufficient. I have to give you logic also. So please understand, please understand. If sales reduce, do you think NPV will reduce? Yes. Sales is inflow. Inflow reduces means NPV also will reduce. But if sales reduce by 1 rupee, do you think NPV will reduce by 1 rupee? No. Why? Sales is in annual terms, NPV is in today terms, present value terms. Since these two things are happening in different points in times, sales reduction by 1 rupee is not equal to NPV reduction by 1 rupee. But if I want to make it comparable, what should I do? Then what should I do? This annual, I should multiply it by annuity factor. Then I get the amount of NPV. Correct? So please observe. So NPV, we got this number, 26640, that is there. Please observe a given solution. Reduction in NPV because of reduction in sales and not sales, present value of sales. How do I make it happen? Sales are multiplied by annuity factor. And that sales, annual sales is how much? my annual sales is actually, so reduction in sales should be sales into annuity factor. Annuity factor is 3.791. So 26,640 divided by 3.791, 7027. So if my sales annually reduced by 7027, if my sales annually reduced by 7027, my NPV will reduce by 26,640, means it will become zero. So if my sales reduce by 7027, NPV will become zero, that is 26,640 will reduce. So selling price sensitivity is 7027 by 2 lakh, annual sales 3.51. Variable cost sensitivity same, 7027 by variable cost 60,000. Fixed cost sensitivity same, that is 7027 by 1 lakh. Initial cost sensitivity same, not 7027. Initial cost is already in present value terms. So 26,640 divided by 1,25,000, 21.31. In fact, this is nothing but profitability index minus 1. You can check it. That number will match up. The solution I've given, you can go through these calculations. And shortcut is this one. You can write down this shortcut for your reference. Selling price sensitivity is NPV by annuity factor by annual sales. A variable cost, again NPV by annuity factor, annual variable cost. Fixed cost is NPV by annuity factor by annual fixed cost. Initial cost is NPV by initial cost, no annuity factor. For units, NPV by annual contribution. NPV by annuity factor by annual contribution. So write down the shortcuts. Oh, I think I have given in the material this. This also I have given in the material. So nothing to write down actually. Okay. One small clarification, my dear friends. We got so many sensitivity, right? 3.51, 11.71, 7.02, 21.31. Can you tell me which one is most sensitive? Initial cost, not highest. Lowest is so sensitive because lower the amount, all of these are resulting in 100% NPV change. NPV becoming zero. So 3.51 small percentage NPV becomes zero. Initial cost 21% should change before NPV becomes zero. So most sensitive is the lowest. Always in life, lowest is the most sensitive. Fine. So while making decisions, you understand the lowest is the most sensitive. This is the first priority. Next priority, second sensitive. Next priority, third sensitive. Fourth sensitive. So when you know the sensitivity, you know the priority, those factors can be given more importance because it is more important. Like that you can do in your life also. You have so many factors. Which is the important sensitive factor for your life to score well? Is it attending classes, writing exams, attending functions, meeting friends, sleeping? Which is more sensitive? You can do the priority analysis. That is what is sensitivity analysis is all about. One more small point. One sensitivity analysis you have already learnt in IPCC, and I have revised at the beginning of this chapter also. When NPV becomes zero, what is that? NPV becoming zero means IRR. At IRR, NPV is zero. So if cost of capital is 10%, IRR is 12%. At 12%, NPV becomes zero. So what is the change? 2 out of 10 change divided by given number. 2 by 10 into 100, 20%. So that will be your cost of capital sensitivity. Nothing but IRR change. Cost of capital to IRR, the percentage change is called as cost of capital sensitivity. Okay, so this is what is part of your capital budgeting. all varieties. I try to include in these 8-9 problems, sufficient for examination. Next session, we will talk about leasing. Thank you.